Jinn and Phyllis were interstellar tourists. They had reserved a flight aboard a sphere which sent travelers to distant stars like Sirius, Arcturus, and Aldebaraan. They sailed aboard a spaceship with a retractable sail. Traveling at near the speed of light, time dilated so that 100 years was only a few weeks of Earth time. One day, lying together on their sides, they saw a glimmer of light in the window. Putting on a spacesuit, Phyllis left out a double trap door, holding on to a rope in one hand and a net in the other. She had used the net before, collecting things that travelers in faster rockets missed out on, like remnants of planets and fragments of meteorites and satellites. She pawed the ground frantically, urging Jinn to open the bottle. Less impatient, Jinn carefully pried off the top of the bottle. Seeing that the paper within was stuck in the bottle, Jinn heeded his wife's suggestion and smashed the bottle with a hammer. The manuscript within was many pieces of paper with small handwriting. Jinn knew the Earth language, having partly been educated on Earth. Phyllis did not know how to read and begged Jinn to read the manuscript. He retracted the sail so the ship could travel slower, and lying down again beside his wife, he started reading. In hopes of averting a disaster to the human race. "Human race?" Phyllis said. "Yes, please don't interrupt," Jinn said. "In the year 2500, we sailed in a ship complete with a vegetable, fruit, and poultry farm. We were traveling to Betelgeuse, which is a huge star in the constellation of Orion, the Hunter. Placed in our solar system, its radius would extend to the orbit of Mars. The ship would take a year to accelerate to near the speed of light, and it would be necessary for it to take a year for the deceleration process. We were not bored, for we learned from Professor Antley more in that year than in all my previous years of existence. The professor had brought along his chimp, Hector. We had three passengers, the professor, Arthur Levain, a young physician with a great future, and myself, Ulysses Maru, a journalist who the professor decided to hire for the journey as a result of an interview. It helped that I told the professor that I was a former chess champion. Even if my story is not published for another 800 years, the feeling of awe produced by such a sight cannot be described as we drew closer to Betelgeuse. Professor Antley discovered the existence of four planets revolving around the central star. One of these resembled Earth. We landed on a planet whose dimensions approximated that of Earth. Our ship was not equipped for a landing. Our ship remained moored in orbit. We departed in one of the launches. Professor Antley took some samples of the outside air and analyzed them. He found that they had the same composition as the atmosphere on Earth. I could discern the outline of continents. The form of coastlines was very different, and nothing in the geography recalled anything from home. We flew over a town. I could make out the general architecture. Broad streets and white houses with straight lines. Two years after leaving Earth, we landed in green grass, which reminded us of our meadows in Normandy. We landed along with Hector at the edge of a lush green jungle. The trees were much larger than those on Earth. We landed in the middle of an Asiatic jungle. It was a waterfall.